So the field monitor comes with the following. With the monitor itself, the 7-inch monitor, and on the back of it, there's a slot for the rechargeable battery, which is already inside of the monitor when you get it, and the plate is screwed in the back, so if you have to replace it, then you just take the plate off and replace the rechargeable battery. But unlike a camera, you don't have to be taking it in and out to charge it, because you charge it with the battery charger that comes with the monitor, and you just plug it into the slot on the back. And on the back, there's all the other different types of connections that you can make with the monitor to a VCR or some other device. For me, I only use the HDMI to connect to my camera, so that's the only port that I'll be talking about in this video. And then it also comes with a table mount, and that is kind of flimsy, but it does the job, like if you have a flat surface like the table is right here. Then it also comes with a shoe mount for your camera, but this device is really flimsy, and if you buy this monitor, you definitely probably won't be using that. And the final part that comes with the monitor is the sunshade, and from what I've heard, you'll probably be buying a better sunshade as well. When I attach it to my camera, I use this shoe mount. It comes from another accessory that I have. But for the purpose of this video, I'm just going to be attaching the monitor to the table mount. And you screw it in. Some reason this doesn't want to go in. Okay, there we go. And then there's another little thing that you have to tighten here, so that it doesn't wobble. And that's the first part anyways. Now, if you buy this monitor, you're also going to need an HDMI cable. And I'm hoping that my camera will focus in on these. But this is the normal connection of the HDMI cable. But to connect to your camera, you're going to need the mini HDMI connector. And so you need this cable, but this cable does not come with the camera. So if you order this camera, you're going to have to buy this cable separately. And it's very easy to connect the whole thing up, because you just take the HDMI cable and plug it into the port on the back of the monitor, and then you take your camera. I have a Canon camera, so on the side there is a slot, and I'm pretty sure the camera will focus in on that. And you just simply slide the cable, get it at the right side, slide the cable in there, and connect it. And that's it basically for the connection. But turning on the monitor, you see on the back there's an on-off switch, and if you look to the front of the monitor, there's also an on-off switch. if you press this switch only, and you don't turn on this switch on the back, the monitor isn't going to come on. So the first thing that you need to do is actually turn that on-off switch on. Now, my monitor came on right away simply because this on-off button was already on. And so when you turn the back on-off switch on, then the monitor turns on. So at the moment, there's nothing on the screen, and so you have to turn on your camera. And once you turn on your camera, then the monitor itself is going to come on. Now, one thing that you do need to know is that depending on on your camera itself, the info button, depending on what that is, I'm just going to move it down, but if you press the info button on your camera, what you're going to see is that the monitor itself, the size of it is going to change. And so make sure, if it isn't, like if it's displaying small like it is right now, then to go to the info button on your camera and press it until you get the full size screen. And basically that's all you need to do to actually connect your camera. To your monitor, and it's very simple to set up. One thing I want to show you is that I kind of wish I had the monitor. You see, on the camera, the LCD screen is not active when the field monitor is active. You don't have both at the same time, which is kind of, to me, a little drawback, because I have a Canon 70D, and at times I want to access the touch screen on the 70D, but I can't do that because this, of course, isn't a touch screen. And so what I do is, going back to the monitor, if you turn the monitor off, and then come back, you see the LCD screen comes back on. And so I use that at times because I have the touch screen display on my Canon 70D, and sometimes I want to change the settings. But once you turn the monitor back on, then it's going to go back to the field monitor. And that's basically it. And if you want to, you know, look at your settings, or you can do all of that that you would normally do on your LCD screen. And there's no card in the camera right now, but that's it for this video anyways. Thanks.